We're talking to Brandon Krause. A lot going on in the boxing world. This Canelo weekend started off a big thing. We have Teofimo Lopez fighting Cambosis. We have David Benavidez this weekend against Davis. His opponent was Kategi. Yeah. Got caught with the worst type.
EPO.
Yes. Why is that so bad? Why is that the worst of the worst?
I agree with that. I think it's much worse to get caught with EPO than like testosterone or something. The reason being, it enhances your endurance. And endurance is such a factor in boxing. Much more so than your brute strength, you know? Well, there's more things to like being on a testosterone regimen than just the strength, you know? There's the recovery that goes along with it, but to extraneously aid your endurance, I think is pretty dastardly in the squared circle.
How about running? How about doing some car, play basketball, soccer, something? So,
well, look, here's the thing with these guys, you know, kind of like a Lance Armstrong. They're not really lazy guys. So Lance wasn't doing this drug regime, so he didn't have to do the training. He was doing the training and the drug regime, which makes you that much more super, right? And that's probably what a guy like Uguazagi what was
Uskategi,
doing.
Uskategi, but yeah.
Whatever. I
former champion.
Right now,
so if he was never tested, how we know he hasn't been doing this from day one? How we know he hasn't been doing this for 5 years?
Absolutely true.
And now, so Benavidez wins. You want to see him fight. How about him and Plant? Because they hate each other. The beef is real.
Yeah, that'd be good.
That'd be good. Okay, yeah. What about Teofimo? How does he do with Cambosis? He told me first round knockout.
Man, I don't know. I still don't know anything about the Australian.
19 and 11 knockouts. Good boxer. Not
all
a lot of
them
power.
Now with all these schedule changes.
Five.
Are just more and more inactive. And you've also heard me say this before. I think that Lopez fought the fight of his life that night when he beat Loma.
He did great.
And he did do great. But it's awful hard to reproduce the fight of your life. You know, kind of by definition, the fight of your life happens one time.
Just one time only.
Not to say he doesn't beat Cambrosis. But I won't be shocked if the Australian wins either.
Okay, then a week after that or a couple weeks after that, you have Tank. And now he's fighting a new opponent, Pitbull Cruz. He beat Magdaleno. That's where we saw him on a tank on the
car. Yeah, I remember that fight. My guy was actually sparring with Magdaleno for that.
Oh, nice. Well, your guy also sparred Tank.
He also sparred Tank, correct.
So what do you think about the fight with Tank?
I think
are you going to be there?
I think Tank takes that fight probably by late KO.
Are you going to be there?
No.
Okay, what about Crawford and Porter?
That's a good one. Everybody knows it's going to be a good fight. And I think everybody also knows that Crawford's going to win.
What about this one?
I apologize. I gotta stretch up my hip.
Very smart. I hurt my knee running with Manny. It still bothers me. I gotta start doing rehab for my knee.
Yeah.
It wasn't my knee. It was the muscles above and under. I never heard of that shit.
Well, that's what your AC. Oh yeah. Well, think that this muscle.
Yes.
Originates here.
You got legs like Mike Tyson. Okay. So wait. Go ahead.
We're not editing it out.
But go ahead. So wait. Tell us what happened, Brandon.
Well, I just say like. All right. We'll use my forearm, right?
Okay.
So here's like the meat of my forearm muscles, right?
Yes.
But the insertion points are on either end of the joint. So that's why, yes, you would feel the pain.
Oh, man, and this pain feels like someone's stabbing me with a fork. So I'm doing it because I'm working, but I need to get into that.
Yeah.
But we spoke about Crawford and Porter. You like Crawford.
Yes.
There's so many big fights coming up. The year's ending up in a black. Jake Paul and Tommy Fury. What do you think? You know Jake Paul. Jake Paul, did he train at your gym?
Yeah, he's been here a few times.
Nice guy, friendly.
Yeah.
What do you think?
I don't have anything to say. I don't have anything to say. You know, like. I have no opinion.
No.
I don't have a negative opinion, but I have no opinion.
Okay. What about a couple more fights that are coming up? So, this is a big one, and I'm very interested. It's a 50-50 fight in my book. JoJo Diaz, DEVIN HANEY. Break it down. You know JoJo. You know DEVIN. December 4th.
Yeah,
the night
you know, and that's a good fun like clash of styles. I don't have anybody running away with it either way. I'll root for the SoCal guy. I'll root for JoJo, but that's a fight. That's a fight that's gonna propel the winner to the next level.
All right, there you have it, Brandon Krause. Stay tuned. He can't pick a winner for that one. The fans are the winners. So hopefully we see you at Tank's fight, December 5th, Staples Center. Elie Seckbach reporting.